Tropical storm Queenie closing in on storm-hit Mindanao. Let's get more details from ABS-CBN's resident meteorologist, Ariel Rojas. Good morning, Ariel.
Hi, good morning, Nikki. Before that, let's give an update as well on severe tropical storm Paeng, which has left the Philippine area of responsibility yesterday at noon. Wind signals have also been lifted last night, but Paeng will continue to move farther away from the country. And gusty conditions will still be experienced in Ilocos Region, Zambales, and Bataan today. The trough of Paeng will also bring moderate to heavy rains in Palawan and Occidental Mindoro, while scattered rains will also be experienced in Zambales, Bataan, and Western Visayas. Inside the PAR, Tropical Storm Queenie with international name Banyan continues to move closer to Mindanao. At 4 a.m. today, it was spotted 430 kilometers east-southeast of Hinatuan, Surigao del Sur, with maximum winds of 65 kilometers per hour and gusts up to 80 kilometers per hour. The good news is Queenie is forecast to weaken into a tropical depression today due to increasingly unfavorable conditions in the area. It will further weaken into a low pressure area by Thursday close to Caraga. Pagasa says despite this weakening scenario, raising of wind signals may still be possible starting tomorrow evening. Starting tonight, Queenie may bring rains over Caraga, Eastern Visayas, and Davao region. Meanwhile, in other parts of the country, the weather will be sunny and warm, but there will be intense thunderstorms this afternoon in Calabarzon, Central Visayas, Zamboanga Peninsula, and Sulu Archipelago. Metro Manila will also be sunny with chances of thunderstorm today. So, latest on the weather, back to you, Nikki.
All right, open for favorable weather today. Thank you so much, Ariel. As always, you stay safe and stay dry.
Electricity has been restored in several areas battered by severe tropical storm Paeng. But as Alvin El Chico tells us, supply of water remains a problem for others.
From over 4 million customers affected during the height of Typhoon Paeng last Saturday, Power Utility Meralco says there are only more than 50,000 customers without power by Monday. These include residents in Cavite and Laguna. One of them is the family of Marilyn Fidel, who is busy cleaning the house devastated by floodwaters.
Yung sa gabi po pag matutulog, napakainit. Buti po kung umuulan, okay lang sana. Kaso ano... Yung pag-charge din, pag nalobat ka, wala na. Tapos yung sa ilaw, pag madilim, minsan delikado din yung mga kandila.
Meralco linemen deployed in the area fixed the busted pole just along the highway, but the utility spokesman appealed for patience.
Tuloy-tuloy naman po yung pagtatrabaho namin. Sabi ko nga, walang pipe, walang tuknat. Hindi kami hihinto hanggat hindi nababalik hanggang sa kahuli-hulihang customer na nawala ng serbisyo ng kuryente.
Residents in the area had a hard time cleaning their flood-affected homes due to low water pressure.
Kung pwede yung nakikiusap po kami na ibalik sa dati yung lakas ng pressure ng tubig para naman kami makapaglinis ng ayos.
But Maynilad explains there was an increase in water consumption in Cavite after the typhoon.
Napansin po namin na lumaki yung demand doon sa aming network. Napansin namin mga 15% yung itinaas ng paghugot doon sa aming mga reservoir. So ito yung nag-cause ng pagkakaroon ng low pressure.
In other provinces, there are still 35 electric cooperatives with partial power restored, while 3 remain without electricity supply at all.
Within siguro po itong this week, may energize na po lahat. Yung pagdating naman po dun sa total power interruptions, hindi namin masigurado kasi po sa NGCP po ang may problem po doon sa linya.
The National Grid Corporation has restored transmission lines in many areas battered by the typhoon, except in 3 provinces.
The entire Aurora, lahat ng customers ng Aurelco, walang kuryente kasi walang transmission services. Completely isolated sila. For Quezon, there's partial transmission services and yung parts of Quezelco One franchise, wala pang kuryente, wala pang transmission services. And today, kasi signal number one pa rin daw sa Benguet. So, Beneco, may parts ng Beneco na walang kuryente.
Internet signal is also back in many areas, Globe says. Its National Capital Region service is fully operational and internet is being restored in several regions. The company has installed charging stations and free calls to typhoon-hit areas. PLDT Smart also has free calls, Wi-Fi, and charging stations in Quezon, Sultan Kudarat, and Maguindanao del Norte. It also gave emergency load to provincial disaster risk reduction management offices. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.